Well, hello everybody. Welcome back to another wonderful day of Sharlenwar's adventure in 7 days to die. So I logged out. There's something crawling up there. So I think they preserved all of that stuff now, which is kind of cool. I kind of like to see that, which is good. So basically once it hits 4 a.m. we're gonna quickly loot this place up here. I want to look inside my thing, but I have a box here at the moment, so I want to go into the map, but it might cause some problems. So I'll start off with you thanking somebody for commenting. So on episode 1, Dougimus, he commented on the video and had a question, and basically it was about this game and kind of my thoughts on it, my opinion. So just to let you know, Dougimus, that I purchased this game mainly because it was an early access game, and at the time, a couple years ago or so, or 3 years ago now, I'm not sure, but I kind of had an attraction to early access games, and this was one of the ones that went on my radar. And it was one of the kind of like the greenlit ones that have shown up on Steam as well. That's kind of how I found out about it, and then I kind of investigated it and went forward from there. So I do have links in the description, of course, to their website, and their website's very limited on all that stuff. there's only so much stuff there, right, to read. There's not enough information, I find. So that's when I went to a YouTube, started to watch other YouTubers, and then now here I am kind of playing the game on my own. I've got about 280 hours invested into the game. So, typically I consider myself a casual gamer. I consider myself someone that plays when the opportunity is there. So usually it's for an hour or 2 hours at a time. And so when I do that, I usually try and record. And so I find that this game is really good with that. Because in single player mode, I think you can hit escape and it pauses the game immediately for you in single player mode. So if you have one of those crazy busy lifestyles and those families, then that's one cool thing I really enjoy about the game. It didn't always do this, but now it does, which is pretty cool. Of course, the time is frozen, so you can't really do anything. Let's go through the options a bit. We never used to have this many options, but now there's more options. You can kind of control how your UI looks. You can have your different resolutions. It's turning VSync on for some reason. I'm not sure why. I'm not sure what this does. VSync. Combat screen tearing by synchronizing the game to monitor refresh rate. Performance impact low. Yeah, so it kind of tells you what this stuff does. Now, I've never actually tried to do this. That's cool. So maybe some of these see very high impact, so I have it turned off. Field of view will have a low impact, so cool. So I play the field of view at 80. Lushable Echo likes to play it at 120, but unfortunately it locks you in at 90 for this version, which is kind of silly. But a level of detail distance I've increased a little bit. Impact is high, so that will definitely affect things. I turned off shadows because, again, I'm on a laptop here, and for whatever reason the mobile platform isn't as good as the desktop platform. So that's interesting. So sun shafts, I always turn this crap off. It doesn't really visually look too much different. If you go look on Lushable Echo's videos, you'll kind of see he plays with the highest settings, and if you compare them, I don't know, I find the lowest settings here still pretty damn good. So they've also done a lot of improvements to the game. Usually over every alpha they've done considerable improvements. There was one time where we kind of skipped out on alpha because of the direction that the game was going in, but they quickly changed that. I think I have alphas from 3 to 11, and then I start to separate them as 12, 13, and 14 now. Right? So I do have footage for all that stuff. Just you go onto my channel and look up 7 Days to Die through my channel, and you'll hopefully see those videos. That's the best way, I think, to find them. And then on any of the videos in the description will be the playlist, so then that way you can just click on that. So on to this game. So what this game kind of feels like to me a bit is I hate to use it just because of the, you know, this used to be all blocks and it used to have a blocky look to it and feel to it. It still kind of does with these blocks, right, when you kind of try and place them. You basically, this more resembled Minecraft back in the day in the first versions of the alphas, so all the terrain blocks were almost identical to terrain blocks in Minecraft, the square voxels. And then slowly through the alphas, they changed it and turned it into the smooth ground to where you can manipulate and change that stuff, right? I'm just going to go ahead and loot. If you piss something off, that's fine. And so, yeah, so that's kind of neat to see the progression. But this game reminds me a lot of Minecraft. Cooking pot, we need that. I've been coming from the Minecraft position, right? Because that was kind of the first open world game I played and I enjoyed. And yeah, and so that's why I kind of gravitated towards this game. Pretty cool game, I find, and in my opinion, cool in the sense that it's kind of like a survival game, which I like. I like kind of survival aspects, so where you have to manage your food and stamina and health and water levels, and that's pretty cool. I like to do all that stuff. What else do I want to talk about this game? I'll talk more about the game as we play. I think it'll be easier to show. So basically, let's go into our bag here. Leather tanning, cool. So we'll read this. So now we know how to leather tan. Awesome. We have our cooking pot, which is awesome. We need to upgrade 3 wood frames. Not sure where we're going to do that. I currently have our bedroll here. We do have a storage chest here at the moment, which is automatically locked. So I'm going to throw all this kind of stuff in here. I'm going to keep the glass jars, but all this other stuff I'm going to throw into here. This wooden club is useless. Keep that. Okay, so this kind of stuff we're just going to keep for now. I'm going to take the dog food with me as food. We don't have water. We don't have... I think that's murky water in there. So I have the zombies on running for a reason, because on our multiplayer server we're kind of doing running zombies as well. And with the 18 hours I can then run out and do stuff like almost right away. Just start, doesn't matter. Bye bye zombies! Okay, so I'm gonna run over to these structures here and I'm going to... maybe we'll catch something running. Okay, we're gonna kinda... there we go, there's the... oh, there's more. So yeah, okay, so why else do I like the game? I like the looting. Looting is quite fun, I find, in the game here. So that's one thing I like to do. I like to kind of explore. I haven't really done very much exploring because I've been waiting for this random gen thing to get to a more kind of reliable state. And now with them promising that we can keep our maps, that tells me that they shouldn't be changing anything that drastically, so that way we would have to kind of restart the map. That's my hopes, because I have plans. So for this place is a bad idea. Going this way, the numbers get smaller, which means Hub City could be in this direction. So I'm going to go this way instead. I'm going to go away from the Hub City a bit, and we're going to see what we can find. Which direction do I need to go? To go this way, I think. Yeah, here we go. Oh, hello, Chicky. Oh, no, it's not Chicky. It's a burning zombie. I was completely wrong. I like the mechanics of the game as well, like the zombie mechanic stuff. And see, the field of view is... see, they changed kind of like the distance. Now we don't want to actually get too close to them, because that will cause them to strike easier, right? Ooh, look at those pants. Some denim pants. Let's kind of wear these bad boys. Now, the problem with all this stuff that you can wear is... there's a temperature thing, and right now I'm gaining heat because of what I'm wearing. So let's go this way. So I was thinking about that place, about the bunker that we were kind of at, and it's a bad place. bad place. And there's a reason for why I think that. It's a bad place because I need to put a wall around all that place. And so that means I need the refined tools, right? So we need to find a place that's more complete, that's above ground, where we can kind of start getting ready for the dog horde, which will be day 5, but knowing little old me, I kind of panic and it gets rough that way. So I'm just going to kind of wander this way. We do have a base that we can run back to at the moment, so not like it's a big deal, but yeah, again, you know, 7 days to die. And so what I've been doing is I've just been using up these axes, and when they break, I make a new one. And that way then you're constantly creating new tools. You can repair them too if you choose to. If you feel you have a good stone axe or something like that, then definitely repair it, because you'll use less plant fibers, you won't use the wood. And so yes, definitely. So now I'm level 18, but as I create them, I get better, right? And your trees, you want to chop down all the way, because you get a bonus. And it doesn't matter to me, I'm going to leave this tree. Wasting a lot of time. Every moment I'm sitting there, yes, you're collecting materials, just feels like wasted time, right? So that's how I feel. Did I pick up that poop? I did pick up that poop. Now, I'm not sure what the human turds are for. Supposedly, you can use them for other things, but I've never really tried. Maple seed, that's cool. They change the seeds. Oh, look at that. We need bird's nest. We need arrows. We basically need ammo. Oh, come on. We need ammo. And I need a different biome. I don't like this biome at all. This biome makes everything difficult. So yeah, so back to Dougimus and his awesome comments. Now, if I got your name wrong, please correct me. Not sure how you would, but yeah, maybe you could kind of let me know how you would. Can I pick up ground? Okay, just weird how it deformed the ground. Okay, yeah, I remember looting these bad boys. Okay. Hey pig. Pig. Just gotta keep up with it, because it will. Ooh, look at that! Flaming pigs! Flaming pigs! Oh, brilliant! Brilliant! I don't have anything to chop it with, so I'm gonna use my stone axe. And it's gonna be a complete waste, and I won't get the leather. Oh no, I do! Okay, cool, got a piece of leather. But you wanna have the bone shiv. And so how are we gonna do the bone shiv? There's a zombie, I think, over there? Yeah, there's a burning zombie there. I'm gonna take care of that, Goy. Goy. Sheesh. Come on. Okay. Now, if you pound on this, I think it gives you... Alright, there you go. Now I can do recipes. Bone shiv, craft. Okay, perfect. Hey, dude. Yo, man. Hey. Yeah, I see you. Yeah, hi. Hi. Oh man, look at that. There we go. I didn't know that these piles of burning wood can actually cause things to go on fire. So that flaming pig was just amazing. I wonder if I can I harvest anything from these? Oh, is that coal? That's kind of cool. So that's fuel. And you get some wood, looks like, from it. That's kind of cool. Garbage trash pile. We'll head back on the road if we don't find any places. So I need to loot these structures here on the side of the road, because, yeah. So let's see how big this biome is. We're going to go as far as we can, and then I think at a certain time we'll head back. I usually like to head back about midday and then kind of hunker down. You do a bunch of stuff around the base, and then you all get ready for the night. You go underground, and yeah, and then you just wait it out. So if we can find as many pigs as possible, that would be great. There's more places to loot over here. Hello, hello. So yeah, oh, cool game. And so yeah, I'm not going to edit this footage this time, just for you, Dougimus. Who knows, maybe I will be editing this. But I've had some issues with some editing. Ooh, look, there's a house. I've had some issues with some editing lately, and so it's just been kind of a little bit rough. And that's why I've been behind with the videos, is just it's hard to do the daily ones at this point in time. So yeah, so I do the videos when I can, when I get a chance to sit down and get to explore the game. So I'm gonna actually head towards that house, because that looks like a promising. There might be a whole bunch of zombies that spawn, so that's gonna be the next fun part. But let's do this. I wanna see if this bug is still here. So there's this, you can scrap this. And then let's see, we got 37 scrap. Come on. See, I get 7 units back, right? So 44. But watch, 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 watch. So they didn't fix this bug yet. Look, you only need 5, so I can produce iron from breaking down. Yes, it's going to consume the wood, but does that matter? And I'm overheating, so now we need to do the good old classic, take off everything. Of course, that takes away protection. There you go. Now I'm naked, Mr. Naked Man. Woot woot! And we can loot this place, and look at this. This is just like the place that we had with Lushable Echo and Jace Machine on our server that we have. And we also had a wicked ass spawn when we came into the area. But you know what? Yeah, there's that spawn. All right, there's this guy. There should be about 10 to 15 zombies. Hello, hello. Hey, where's my thing? Oh yeah, 'cause I'm building a new one. Let's run over here a bit. Okay, let's make sure we. Where is it? Throw this back. Oh, look, that's way better. See? Look at that. Hello, hello. Come on. Yeah. Okay. So it's definitely they changed the way they do everything now. Yeah. Just have to remember the point of view. Whew. Hey, biatch! Oh yeah, sorry about the swearing. If you guys don't like it, I apologize. Oh, hello, fireman! 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 Oh no, 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 no! No, really? I don't have water. I have band-aids. Ah, it goes away. I think I walked on this stuff. So this is a worse biome to be in actually than what we are in with Lushable. With Lushable, we're in kind of like a city biome, right? This is the burnt biome. And why am I meleeing all of these? I don't know. Let's start shooting them. There we go. You think he was attacking the other zombie? Or was he because he was in his way, or were they trying to go after me? There we go. Got your brain. Okay. Ooh, that was pretty close. Oh, come on, this guy's like invincible. There we go. Now can we loot these bad boys before they disappear? Oh, that's a good one. Has a hat that will help with heat. That's glass. That's scrap. Oh man, I'm quite loaded actually. We can scrap that. We can wear that. Okay, so that means screw the glass. Okay, so maybe we'll hang out here for today, and we'll kind of create our stand here. Okay, let's do that. Let's scrap these. Let's make a secure storage chest. We do have some of these wood frames, and we're gonna do exactly what we did in the multiplayer. I'm just gonna just build a pound up a quick wall here, and we'll just make sure, yeah, we'll make sure that we continue our quest, and basically we will just build a wall all the way around this place. I think it will be doable by one person, I hope. Otherwise, the 7-day horde is gonna be just terrifying. I need to collect some materials here. And so yeah, this is it. I get to craft a bedroll now. Bedroll. I like the crafting system now. That's another kind of thing that's different. It used to be the Minecraft style, but now it's the lookup, so I like those changes as well. I like the crafting system. I like how you can collect the materials now, the way they do. The Alpha 14 is a really nice change. But for you, those of you looking into kind of like early access games and, hey, should I play that game or not, or whatever, well, I don't know. It depends on the style of game you like, right? If you like to do this kind of stuff, do a lot of harvesting, standing still, maybe looking in your inventory, we'll repair this time, and look at it. See, now it's a little bit lower quality, and yeah, and see, and here we go, we continue playing. We should still get skill. I don't know if this is a good biome though, because I'm still heating up. Shit, this is gonna be a bad place. I don't even know how to counteract. Oh, brutal, you're locked. Because I don't have anything, I'm not wearing anything. I actually should be at minus 7, right? So. Oh, come on. But there is a door. Oh, I guess I should eat this. There is a thing upstairs. We can eat this as well. Okay, and hopefully there'll be water in here that's not murky. Let's see here. And hopefully there'll be food in here. There we go. We do have to go into deep. We break into these things. There could be recipes here. Does this give me minus? No. Scrap that. We got some seeds. Some coffee beans, that's cool. Locked, come on, man. This is a relatively new feature as well, I think as of Alpha 13 maybe? Because they started to block up everything. Used to be able to access everything, no problem. Doors were wide open, and kind of had a weird feeling as well. Why is everyone kind of leaving everything open, right? So, yeah. Interesting. Okay, no, that's cool. Empty. Let's check up here. There's a door up here as well. Is this open? No, it's locked. Okay. We get your regular leather out of these. There's also these refrigerators. Then we got sinks. We got all those items. Oh, more bottles. Did we miss water? I don't think we missed water. I don't think I found any water. A cabinet here. Oh man, I want to eat that. So we'll do this. Do that. Click on it. Go eat. Oh shit. Oh shit. Okay. I'll take the risk. Okay. I kind of want to build here now, and I think we'll be okay. We just need to build the wall, so, which means I need to go on a major harvesting spree. And I need to finish off with kind of, you know, why would you want to buy this game? Why would you want to buy this game? Well, I bought it because I like survival games. That's kind of the genre I like. Whoa. Oh, because I'm probably full. I like survival games, so I like that genre, right? And I felt that this was a good kind of entry into that whole thing, right? So let's throw a bunch of stuff in here. Let's actually throw that in here. Let's throw this stuff. We could maybe live out here. We'll have to kind of see if we can build a forge. I only have to collect 20 of these. They reduced the number. We could plant a maple seed here. We should place our bedroll, a new bedroll in here. Maybe. Let's just throw a bunch of this stuff in here. We'll keep the bone shiv and we'll plant the maple seed. Can I just plant these in the dirt here, or do I have to have fertile dirt? Yeah, it looks like you need specific dirt. Okay, that's not a problem. What time is it? It's actually 10 o'clock. Okay, it's just dark in this biome, which seems to be relatively large. So I'm gonna go save waypoint here. Gonna go home. Gonna go bomb shelter. Okay, then we're gonna go over here. We're gonna go save waypoint. We're gonna go house. Okay, perfect. So that way we know we have possible locations to hang out in. So maybe we'll hang out at this place for tonight. See kind of what happens. I'm going to kind of run around here, harvest a bunch of materials here. And yeah, maybe the next episode I'll kind of start with the nighttime. Well, I don't know. Maybe, maybe not. We'll see. But you know, the video's gotten pretty long. So yeah, I keep derailing myself. I apologize. Why would I buy the game? I like harvesting games. I like kind of building games. I like being creative. I like the zombies. I like having to have a reason why I'm building these bases, fortresses, forts. Why I'm building all the crafting stuff. That was creepy. Is that the skeleton? Is that what we're contending with? Oh. Hello, hello. That's what died. It was a rabbit. It's creepy. Yeah. This is a freebie. Look at that. Nice. So we got another hide. Maybe two hides? No gore block. Cool. This might be an interesting biome to be in general because of these things. These rocks are the best rocks to pound out. Because they give you stone and iron scrap. So that's very important. There is a lot of grass out here. There's not too much, but there is enough to do that. Why would I buy the game? Be like your third time here. You're like, what are you doing? Okay. I don't know. Because I would buy the game just because it's like, it reminds me a lot of like Minecraft. Not so much now, but just the building aspect. Just I like the harvesting aspect. I like the survival aspect of the game. I like the fact that they moved a lot of the stuff into the skill trees here. We have 5 points available. Interesting. And yeah, I don't know. I just like the game in general. I can sit in the game, play for hours, and it doesn't bother me at all. It feels like I haven't spent that time. Like looking at the clock here, looking at 26 minutes, right? That is unusual. I'm supposed to get bones from that. Yeah, it's unusual because usually, you know, some games drag on, other games are relatively good. Sometimes you get lost in games, sometimes you don't. Just this one feels just good. And, you know, it's hard to tell that I've spent the 200 and some odd hours in the game. That's actually a complete shocker to kind of look at that. It's like, wow, I played this game for 280 hours. That's like more than a lot of games I've played. Not to mention you look on my channel, and what do you see a lot of content of? Well, 7 Days to Die. All right, this is the game that kind of caused me to create YouTube videos on a regular basis. It's the game that got me out of kind of like the Minecraft kind of recording into this stuff, into 7 Days to Die. So for those of you on the fence, well, if the money is a lot and, you know, if 27, 28 bucks, well, for me it's Canadian, but if 30 bucks is a lot, then I would maybe wait, maybe look at what happens with the development, kind of follow along on the dev blog, just kind of keep an eye out as to what changes are occurring in the game. Kind of just read the patch notes, and you know, they do fix their problems, and I find the game really polished now. It's really nice now. Got a lot of murky water, so we'll have to make a campfire and maybe make some water. So let's do that here. I'm gonna go back to the house and let's do that. Let's make some water. Oh, I'm wet. Nice. Let's make a secure wood door. Door, secure wood door. I don't feel safe with this open. We need to make wood frames as well. We also need to upgrade. So, is it left click to place? No, left click to move. Bang. Okay. Okay, let's upgrade this. This is also... Okay, I need concrete for that. Okay, good. So maybe this is a good house to hunker down in. Ah, dang it.
Woo!
Hi. 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 Oh, there's another one coming. There we go, that's a good shot. Yes, you betcha, we're doing this. Nice. Cool. Any more zombies? Screw off, zombies. I want to finish off the video. So yeah, this is what it's like. This is the game. If this is kind of cool and you like this kind of movement, every 7 days we have zombie hordes, you know, and if not, just follow along and continue to follow along, you know, as long as you can watch the content, of course. And yeah, we'll kind of go from there. I do have a cooking pot, so we're actually going to make, I have 6 murky water, so we're going to actually make a campfire here, and then we're going to call it a day. Campfire. We go craft. Dang it, is that a zombie or is that me? I think that's me, because I'm getting low. Okay, we'll throw the campfire right here. We got some trash here. Let's break that. Okay. Oh, there you go, I completed the quest. Bam, bam, bam. You can only get one skill point, though, so that's the bummer about it. I right-click that, see what would happen. Perfect, okay, now let's make some bottled water here. We can make 6, which means we need a minute 52. I'm only going to put in what I need. Okay, and we're going to go click on cook, and it should turn it on for me. And boom, bada bing, we're making water. As soon as it outputs the water, they changed this interface a bit. They cleaned this up, they made it a little bit nicer. That's pretty cool. But yeah, but I don't know, Dougimus. If you're still watching this, thank you. I appreciate your eyeballs. I appreciate you taking the time to watch my video. Appreciate you, yeah, just taking the time. That's awesome. All right, and if you did subscribe, hey, thank you. If not, well, that's fine too. Maybe one day I'll convince you. So, I would say if you want to pick up the game, do it. You know, if 30 bucks doesn't really mean anything to you, then you go for it. If 30 bucks seems like a lot of money, then maybe follow along and watch, right? You continue to follow along with Jace Machine. You maybe kind of check out my brother, Illustrable Echo. Check out what I've got. You know, check out all my old content as well. It might be good. I don't know. You know, it might be cringeworthy now if I look back, just because I feel I've done a lot of changes with myself and with kind of the style and how I produce these videos and all that stuff. Because for me, making these videos is just about fun. And it's more of recording this as I play, so that way I can play the game. Because I like playing video games, but it's brutal. It's hard to play when there's other stuff going on, right? So like my family's at home now, and it's getting really noisy over there. And so I think it's time to call it. So yeah, so thank you. And thank you everybody for watching. I appreciate it. And yeah, following this will be some more multiplayer content, so enjoy that. And I will see you all in the next episode. Bye-bye. Okay, doing good. Now what do I have? I got 2 blueberry pies.
That's good.
And then there's some canned stuff I have, which I'll probably end up eating, but...
Yeah, I'm trying to stick around the 50% mark. Like, when I get down to like 25, that's when I eat.
I should head back soon, shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you find any water? That's
murky water, yeah.
Okay, that's good, because we got the pot, so we can...
Got 3 murky water, so...
That's good, yeah, okay.
A little bit. I didn't find any sources yet, though. Found another kind of point of interest path.
Well, wherever that river was that Jace found.
I also found on the way between there and here a pond.
Oh, cool. What is this?
Did you happen to mark it?
Oh, look at this. I found a cemetery.
I didn't find on my radar.
That's freaking cool.
Map, I mean.
There's like a cemetery.
Yeah, cemeteries are new and they're awesome.
Holy shit, that's awesome. I need to get out of here.
I have not broken into a casket yet, but I'm curious as to what may be inside.
Oh, there's a lot of zombies that spawn, though.
Actually, Navistein has a cemetery, so it's not really new.
I just would never been there.
It's new to...
Yeah, we have. Remember that random church ahead?
Okay, and yeah, yeah. Okay.
If you dig by the gravestone, there's a coffin, like a chest. And like
yes, yes. And yeah, and there's loot in there.
There's like bones and crap in it.
Yeah. Okay, I'm going to start heading back. I'm going to head back through the wilderness a little bit so that we can loot these little structures. Because there's a whole bunch of zombies that started to spawn at that cemetery, so it got really scary. Oh, there's a death safe right here.
Up there, that safe exists.
Save waypoint. Desk safe. Cool. So I marked there's a desk safe in the middle of the ground here. Like on the floor, on the ground, right? So I put a marker to it so I can come back to it once we have tools to open into it.
Glad that fixing stuff up isn't so much wear and tear on your tools as breaking stuff down is. Stone axe just seems fun forever.
Yeah. Did you put your bedroll down in the... Oh, actually couldn't have...
Oh, shit.
Not
scary.
Yet. Just to let me know if any zombie hordes come at me before I get a chance to, and I'll risk it.
Well, I gotta make a ladder here first, and then you'll be able to...
You can even put the bedroll down.
The Raffy will not be able to join.
That's no. Okay.
I am officially
holy
out
crap.
Of
you only make one ladder at a time now.
Wow. Yeah. Some more murky water. Oh, shit, will I make it back in time? That's the next question. Still has spawning issues, I noticed, with some of this stuff. I don't know, I went as far... I went till noon, and so now I'm going back.
Okay. Okay, so ladder's in, so you can get to the...
Nice.
House now.
Hey, Gusta.
So if you want to put your bedroll down now, you can.
Found actually bottled water.
See, the first perks I'm getting are that, the ones for the, where is it? The survivor one and the run forest run ones.
Nice, yeah.
Because those ones will allow you to last longer on food and water and running, so I think those are the most important right now.
Yeah.
For early survival.
Anything with stamina, I think.
I've taken that first level of survivor and already, like, I'm lasting a lot longer on the food than I would have.
Oh, you have? Oh, shit. I should look into that right now.
Every couple levels, you can...
What page is it on?
First. Called survivor. It's like the first one.
Like run... Oh, there's run... Oh, there we go. There's survivor.
It's right above run.
So is your metabolism. Woo! Oh, has a little funky music, too.
Oh, I love it. It's wacky. Took me by surprise the first time. It does. It feels pretty awesome. But it totally stumbled me the first time. I was like, whoa!
I achieved something.
My actual true reaction was captured in my first episode that I put up about an hour or two ago.
Yeah, well, you just captured my reaction. So.
Woohoo!
That is interesting. Amazing. That's exciting. Can loot some of these places. I need to unload, really.
So far, ladders seem to be working a lot better. More.
That's good to hear.
Yeah.
Explains why they're so much tougher to build. They're better made.
Well, it's hatch. I always want to make trapdoor instead of hatch.
Yes.
Yeah, it used to be trapdoor, but then they changed the name of it.
And you don't need a block in front of it anymore, too.
Ah, nice.
So that's done. Good. Now we just need to...
Nice. And yeah, and it feels much nicer to go up and down the ladder, that's for sure.
Yeah. Okay.
That's exciting. Okay, cool. So where's the door in? Oh, look.
Look at what?
I want to try and hit this thing. There we go.
Oh, chicken? It was in the house?
No. It was caught on the... thing up here.
Well, that's good to have chicken spawning. Nice, now we just need a bone shiv or something.
I got, I have, like, a knife.
Oh, nice.
That I found, nice. A hunting knife.
So, once you get enough... Oh, you probably have enough bars to make a grill, right?
I never even thought about that.
If you were taking cars apart, you should.
Yeah, you don't get as many pipes as you think you'd get off them anymore. But I will definitely run inside here and check how many I got total.
Because we have eggs there, right? So.
Yeah, I found some eggs too.
Eggs also.
Making eggs would be a good thing. Unless they've changed it.
I'm just basically dumping everything into this box. Murky water.
I'm gonna collect some wood.
I'll throw a thousand.
I actually planted the pine seed down here, so we should get a pine tree at some point, which is good. I don't know why a zombie would be carrying a pine seed. But...
He was a botanist or something.
Yeah, who might have complained, right?
No.
Because we're quickly deforesting the area. Right?
Doing good work. Doing the Lord's work here.
Oh, jeez.
Ooh, there's an untouched toilet here. How'd that happen?
Oh, because I haven't gone to the bathroom yet.
I miss
the days. That's a good thing you found it.
Yeah. I miss the days of using toilets as water sources.
Yeah, me too. What's this? What's this? Ooh.
What?
It's like a cave pit.
Oh, good. If there's a cave there, that's great.
I don't know if it's a cave, but it's a pit, and I can see resources down here.
That's a cave, then. That would make this...
Yeah, it's kind of like a cave, but it's exactly... Exactly.
So then we just need to...
It has the stalactites and stuff and mites in it, but... And then you see resources, but then it's just like a pit. It's not really a cave, which is good. So where is that compared to here? Oh, yeah, it's a black... On the map, it's a little black spot. Okay.
Probably is a cave.
No, it is, but it's just, there's
shit.
No...
Okay. Need to go eat.
Oh yeah, and how you like the animals now, Jace, the little animals.
They're adorable.
No, but they're easy to hunt, I find. They get, if you're behind them, they don't see you, and they don't seem to run away. So then they're
got a chance to notice.
Yeah, we're going to have to break this door down.
Up top there? Yeah.
Yeah.
Someone has to. There's a zombie here.
Holy crap, it's got multiple levels to it.
So I broke into this house earlier when I died, and I didn't tell you guys what had happened. I was just like, ah. Oh. Instead of coming in through the door, I went in through the window, and the second I broke through the window, a zombie was waiting on the other side of the wall and hit me from the side. I don't know.
Wow.
It
was nice.
Very abrupt, and I was running from another zombie at that time, so I was like, I ran in, turned around, was throwing down, or about to throw down, a wooden frame in the doorway, and the zombie was like, what are you doing in my house?
That's funny.
I'm sorry, sir, I didn't know it was occupied.
I find them harder to hit now, actually. Zombies,
we got 9 bomb at the last.
Their heads do more sway, I find.
Yeah. Might be true.
Well, I'm having challenge with them. Unless it's been a while since I played, and that's why I'm rusty again. That could be too. Because I noticed...
You could say that it makes you feel better. I'll go with it, man.
You're going to scrap, empty cans, do them one at a time.
Really?
And you get full value for them.
Really?
Hey, where's the one with the talking pot? Here it is. Okay, let's hope this doesn't spawn any screamers. Goodness, no. Only 9.
Oh, you mother fricker! Oh, what the hell?
What?
There we go.
You died?
No. Just the stupid hills here are the bumps and stuff. Just make it difficult to
rough terrain
to kill the zombies with, right? So I just was missing, and she hit me somehow. And
oh shit! I should be using gears.
I know they changed the ambient noises too. They're really creepy now. It seems
is always a good thing.
So no, I'm not saying it's bad. It's something new I've noticed. Yeah, they added some more, I guess.
Oh, we're gonna need some lights down.
Your stuff into the music track, right? So there's more kind of like the ambient stuff in there. So did you actually read the entire list that they posted for the changes?
Nope.
I was reading through it. I don't know if I literally read the whole list, but I know that they were recently recording, like a month or two ago. like a bunch of original sounds for the game.
Right.
Like those have been implemented. I like the new little guitar riff and the little piano diddly that they added.
Yeah. I don't like the starting theme anymore. I like the original one that they had.
Well, they can't use that one anymore because that was licensed. I've gotten copyright strikes on it, actually.
Really?
Yes, absolutely. And I've looked it up. A lot of people have. They licensed it from the company, but they're allowed to use it. But we, the end user, are not allowed to use it.
Yeah.
So you might get a strike on your videos.
That's fine. I don't monetize mine anyway.
So I don't either. They might catch you for you.
And it's not a strike. It's just a match through.
No, exactly.
It means nothing. I got those from like one of my Mad Max videos and stuff. It's like,
I'm fighting one of those on a StarMade video on Bug Zero's music, and I found the artist whose music it supposedly ties up with, and it's this guy in South Africa who I've been talking with. We're trying to figure out what the problem is, but it's true that there is a track that he has. It's not him either. It's a company that represents him that's coming after me. So
interesting.
I'm trying to work with him to figure out how we can stop this, because this is the third time I've been hit over the same song in as many weeks.
Right.
Well, it could be that they're using the same track together, right? So
the same piece of it, or
This guy's not using the same. He's not using a chopped version of Bug Zero's tune.
But I mean, like if they made it in like GarageBand or something, right?
This guy's got like over 9,000 tracks. He's like a really big deal in South Africa, apparently.
Okay.
I called him out on Twitter because I thought it might have been him. So I was like, "What the hell is with this shit?" He was like, "Whoa, dude."
Nice.
I was like, look, all right, I can see that my anger was aimed at the wrong person, so let's see if we can figure this out.
Ooh, these things have level. But I'm
furious over that stuff, man.
Yeah.
They're my damn pennies.
Yeah, well, see, I figure...
pennies, and I want them.
I figure with enough subscribers, I'm going to just kind of do like a Patreon campaign.
Yeah, that's what I would do.
I figure I will at some point.
And once you know, you can get enough people willing to just pay $1 a month, you know, like...
Yeah.
That's all I need. I just need a few thousand people, about 3,000 or 4,000 people doing $1 each.
That's exactly how I feel. Like, with my subscriber base, I haven't quite hit 3,000 yet. And I don't feel right going with the Patreon thing yet.
Yeah.
But maybe soon. You know, after 3,000, I'll start considering it seriously.
And then you don't have to worry about if YouTube were to ever go away or whatever, right? You can just move to some other platform and that Patreon sticks around.
Yep.
Seems like a pretty solid option. If people like you and your content, then, you know, works out.
Exactly.
You don't have to worry about copyright strikes and crap like that.
Oh, yeah.
That's how you evolve, right? That's how you continue to do what you do, so you can always do what you love, right? If this is what it is.
Exactly. If a company thinks they can make money off of my videos just by doing the match third part content, more power to them. I don't really care. I'm using their stuff, so fine.
Make some money off it. I'm not using their stuff, and they're striking me, and that's where I specifically go out of my way not to use their stuff. Yeah. It's Kevin MacLeod.
So you know you can use your people's stuff.
I know some people have gotten copyright strikes using his stuff too.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I know too.
So it's funny.
Really. Like, they know that, YouTube has a very small crew of people who actually look at these things.
Yeah.
And that's why they give you 30 days. Yeah, much of it is automated. But if you have like a strike, if you're going to contest something, basically it gets kicked back for the person who's putting the strike in and for YouTube, the review. And usually what happens is these companies will keep the video under review just long enough to take, you know, a few cents from you, but not to have it long enough for YouTube themselves to actually see how legitimate it was. And they actually get to keep the money generated on your video during that time period.
Okay. Yeah.
That does not come back to you.
No. Interesting.
And so they do this to large amounts of people, and what you end up having is a lot of money. It's just a lot of pennies from different sources.
Yeah. Well, exactly. If you do enough pennies.
And if you're not a very savvy YouTuber, you're not going to notice that you might have a copyright notice on a video. And of course, it's set up to says, hey, if you're fine with this, do absolutely nothing.
Yeah,
exactly. So it favors the people who are stealing your pennies.
Yeah.
And like I said, if you do it to enough people, that's a pretty good racket to be running.
Okay, I'm getting... Okay, hold on. So why am I getting lag when I come to where the house is here? Interesting.
Because it loves you. House shows you that it loves you. It's
probably that light.
You with arms.
That bitch is that light. But, oh, well, whatever. That's fine.
What?
I don't know, just whenever I come back to a certain part of the map, it just, I get bad frames. But then when I'm here, the frames are fine, so it's just
weird. I've got a torch in the house.
Oh, everything looks...
Anything to do with it.
So now everything's fine now, so it's just when I come near it. It's weird.
I don't have any issues.
No, well, welcome to my world.
I don't want to be in your world.
No, you don't.
That's why I upgraded my computer. I was tired of that world.
I was tired of that world also.
One day.
Man,
this one's good.
I spent forward to upgrading for so long.
I spent $1,500 on my computer to make sure I was out of that world.
Wow. Yeah, $1,200 on my end.
I said, okay, how much memory can this thing hold? Okay, max it out.
I have 16 gigs plus 8 in my 8 in my graphics card.
Yeah, I got 32 my system, I think 16 in my graphic card.
Wow.
Nice. Very good.
I think the memory is your biggest bang for your buck, especially in this game.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
Because before I was running on a machine, I think it had like 8 gig, maybe.
Okay.
There we go. So our wall is upgraded all the way around, I think. Yeah. And now here come the spikes. So...
making some blueberry seeds here.
Yeah, I'm kind of placing...
I'm going to grab some scrap iron now from the house. I want those to go up to scrap right away.
Like scrap
iron. That's why we need better tools now. The next day, we have to go on a hunting run. We got to get some those hides.
Yeah.
Why is there like a club on the floor here?
What kind of club?
A wooden club and some oil just sitting on the floor here.
I'm not sure
about the oil. I thought it looked nice there. I dropped it there. I was making something. Okay. I thought it would look nice. I figured it would get to a...
Yeah, I moved into the chest here. It's just kind of weird. I come in and there's stuff on the floor.
Yeah, because it probably takes however long. This is cool. I like this kind of base that we've got.
Yeah, it's not bad.
I even like the... Like the whole...
Like we're on day two. It's a good start. You know,
yeah. Like... It's amazing.
Spend all the rest of this time just scavenging, protecting the base, get ready. Like this was like a day one. Like,
yeah, I've been dumping food and stuff like that into here, so.
No, it was a really fortunate find because we found it like right away. So.
Yeah.
Usually spend half your day just looking for a
place. No one's found any honey or anything like that, hey?
No.
Okay.
Oh, you're still. Oh, there's in that chest. There's antibiotics. Oh, I hear zombies.
Is there antibiotics in here?
I thought I saw some there. Here.
Oh, I did not.
Oh, horde. It's coming.
So what?
Zombie horde's coming.
Do they know about us or are they going to pass us by?
Well, I'm crouched
right
now.
They're going to pass us by if you're quiet and crouched.
I'm crouched right now, so.
If they walk
No,
now we're sensed. At least I'm sensed. Okay, I'm
undetected.
Back corner here should be okay.
Ah, shit.
Oh, now they're gonna bang on the wall, right? Okay. So
we have one game hour to finish them, basically.
Yeah. Okay, so we have to...
Just run.
You got arrows. Now it'll be time to use them.
Oh, shit. She moves. I need to come down here.
Run away. Whoa. Ouch.
Oh, my character's hungry. Now he's really hungry.
There we go. Is that it?
Nope. Fuck me. He took a lot of hits.
Oh, shit.
Oh, there we go.
She down? Okay. that it?
There we go.
I don't see anyone else coming, unless...
No, the rest of them passed by. There was just a couple, one that got stuck on the wall here and started banging.
It's like that police guy, right? Okay.
That's why, yeah, that's why you need the... Once you get spikes all around them, it doesn't matter.
Yeah. Drink this.
We got... Okay. At least we got... I cooked up the murky water, so at least we got a few waters.
I got deposit some... I have extra
and
meat.
I got some food. And that zombie, I got some food. I'm gonna... Go ahead and do the sham sandwich thing, just cause whatever.
Okay, I'm just sorry.
50-50.
There we go.
At the worst, you lose one wellness, so whatever.
So you said one at a time for the... Okay, for the... Okay, cool, I like this. So how do you do this one at a time, this empty can thing? Do you have to split them or something?
Yep.
Well, you know, I don't know if it really affects it, but I assume to notice that it's easier to keep the temperature inside the house, fill up the cracks.
Okay, sure.
I've had it happen, actually. I've been able, like, if you have a fire going and you have any source open to the air, you might, you can lose body heat. But when I've encased myself in boxes, like up against the wall,
yeah,
then I stop freezing to death immediately.
Well, there's no temperature issues.
They're not necessarily here.
Okay.
I'm just saying.
Yeah. I know, in that one playthrough you did, yeah, that was pretty brutal to be in that cold area, right? And have no way of heating other than...
I didn't really mind it so much, to be honest. Uh-oh.
What?
Zombie on the horizon.
Yeah, that's fine. As long as you're inside and they don't see you, you're good.
Yeah, well, I'm going to go inside. Got a wood frames in the doorway there. You guys are inside as well?
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
This is the good old-fashioned hunker down and wait. This is what we used to do when they first were on running as well.
Back in the day.
And then we turned it off because we just got tired of it.
Old Lushable and I used to wait in the dark and tell a ghost story. It's about the time the zombie got them.
Yeah. And one time the candlelight would slow them down. So they would stop running, so...
Well, torches. There was torches.
Yeah. Torches. Yeah.
That was good, because then you could just set up a printer of lights, and then, you know...
And that's where we had our kill systems and stuff, and we created all those different cool walls and stuff. That's lots of good footage that we have back in the day.
Yep.
I'll take a break with my recording here. Hold on a moment as we end this episode.
Yay!